So before making this video, I installed ES File Explorer just to compare it with the Solid Explorer. And oh boy, it is completely different from what I have seen few years back. There is a space analyzer, cleanup tool, and of course there are ads that don't even look like one. Now I am glad that I have switched to Solid Explorer. But what about the feature? Is it as powerful as ES File Manager? Well, let's find out. Hi there, this is Pinar once again, and yes, Solid Explorer is as powerful as ES File Manager, but unfortunately most of its features are hidden or less known, and that's where Vue comes in. So in this video I'm going to show you cool things you can do with Solid File Explorer. So without any further ado, let's get started. Number 1. Dual Panel. Now this dual panel might not look like a big deal to you, but I think it is the only file manager that does this. So what exactly is dual panel? Well, it does something like this. If I rotate my Android to the landscape mode, then Solid Explorer will show two independent file browser panel. From here, you can either copy paste or move around stuff just like you do on computer. Now I wasn't aware of this feature before using this application because you know it's so unobvious. But ever since I came across it, I kind of started using it every day. Number 2, access your Android files from other devices. Now usually I use AirDroid for this feature, but Solid Explorer works pretty well too, especially given that it has a dedicated FTP plugin to make the entire process seamless. So here is how it works. Install the Solid Explorer FTP server from Google Play. Next, open the Solid Explorer app, go to FTP option and then tap on start, and that's it really. Now if you go to any computer browser and type this URL, you will have the read access to all your Android files. Though applications like AirDroid give you both read and write access, but at least you can make the interface pretty by typing the URL in the file explorer. Also, some of you might not know this, but using this feature you can also use your Android files from anything that has a web browser, even your iOS devices. So next time you have a problem connecting your Android to iPhone, maybe try this option. Number 3, access your PC files from your Android. Now the app that lets you access your Android file from other devices are quite common. But how about accessing your PC or Mac from your Android? And well, guess what, with Solid Explorer you can do that. Simply turn on the network discovery on your computer and then go to your Android phone and open up the Solid Explorer app. Tap on the plus sign and then on new cloud connection and then select LAN and Samba, and you should see your computer listed here. Select that and then enter the login username and password of your computer. And here we go. Of course, you can also stream videos or download anything from your computer to Android. Though just in case if you are having a problem connecting your computer to Android, let me know in the comments below and I will make a step-by-step tutorial for you. Number 4. Hide media files from gallery. Okay, so let's consider this situation. You have some photos that you would like to hide from your gallery. Say it's your WhatsApp photo album. Now one way to do this on Solid Explorer is simply select that folder and tap on hide. This will hide your folder from the file manager only, which you can find in the hidden folder option. But there is a better way to do that. Since Android is built on Linux kernel, you can use their way to hide folders. That is, simply add a period in front of the folder name, and this will hide the folder both from the file manager as well as from the gallery app. And to make that folder visible again, simply go to the folder option and check mark show hidden files. Number 5. Password protect. Now hiding files will only protect you from the people who don't know how it works. But what if you are dealing with the sensitive data? Then it's better to password protect your files. So here is how to do that with the native encryption of Solid Explorer. Simply select the folder and then tap on encrypt option. But there is a problem with this approach. The encrypted folder will have .sec extension, and if you send this to your friend via email or something, then they will have to install Solid Explorer to open that file. Not a good situation, right? But again, there is a better way to do this. Instead of going with the encryption, archive your file, and this will create a zip file which you can also password protect. So basically you're getting the same thing, but this time anyone can open the program from any platform. Of course, they will still need the right password. Though if you're dealing with the sensitive data, make sure you upload a copy of it on your cloud as well. because even though no one can view a password protected file without a password, nothing is stopping them from deleting it. So yeah, take a backup. Number 6, extract content. So let's say you are playing a game like Duet and you really like its music, or you came across a new wallpaper app whose wallpaper you would like to change with time. Of course, you can do that with Tasker, but to get there, you will have to see what's inside the application package. So here is how you can do that. Take the backup of this application to get the APK file, or go to the apps folder and select the APK from there. Next, simply open the APK with the app viewer and you can browse all its content. Usually the content that we are looking for is available under the media folder. And from here, you can copy the content or use it for your personal use. Though make sure you don't use for any commercial angle or anything, because that is not only wrong but also illegal. Number 7, edit your host file. Now, most of you might not know this, but Solid Explorer also comes with a built-in Root Explorer, though you will have to turn on this option by going to your settings. Now, what you can do with the Root Explorer? Well, you can do pretty geeky stuff if you have root access to your file system, like uninstall system applications, modifying app data, or even edit your host file. Okay, so let's say for any reason you want to block a particular website, like for your children or for any other reason. Then you can simply edit the host file of your device by mapping the website name to the local host. Open up the host file using a text editor and then put the local IP address to the website name that you want to block, and that's it. Number 8, install any application as system app. Now first thing first, why would you do that? Well, a good example is Cerebrus, an anti-theft app. So if I install Cerebrus as a system app, then even if the thief factory reset my phone, the Cerebrus app will survive that. Though of course, you will need the root access to do stuff like that. So here is how it works. All you have to do is move the app folder from the user app to the system app, and that's it. You don't even have to configure the permission settings like you have to do in the ES File Explorer. Solid File Explorer will take care of everything. Also, in case you want me to do more videos on root application, then just let me know in the comments below. Well, this is all for now. Like always, if you enjoyed this video, then go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up. Also, if you want to get notified whenever I publish a new video or for any other channel that you follow, then don't forget to click on the bell icon. YouTube algorithm has changed a lot. So that's it for now. Subscribe to this channel to see more awesome videos, and I will see you in the next one. Until next time, thank you for watching.